Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video we're going to take a look at an alternative to Illustrator's Intertwine. Now Intertwine is a great feature to change the stacking order of objects, and it's great for very different kind of objects, so you can use it on nearly all kinds of Illustrator objects. So let's just select this one, and in order to make a Celtic knot out of that, you go to Object, Intertwine, Make, and then with the lasso that shows up, you can just circle the parts where you want to change the stacking order of those objects. And then Illustrator changes them. Intertwine gets a little difficult when you want to edit it later, and also when you want to later edit a gap to this between these objects, then it gets difficult. You need to prepare a lot before you actually create this intertwine. So when you want to have the ability to later edit your intertwine, and when you are working with certain simple kinds of objects, let's talk about charts like org charts or flow charts, and these need to be edited a lot maybe, and they are also quite simple, and then you can use a feature in a different app, Inkscape, which is a free application and it has this nice feature. So let's take a look at it. I have created the same kind of artwork here, which are just some circles with some fat strokes applied. And I'm going to select all of them and then group them. So object, group, just like in Illustrator. Now it's a group, and then we can add an effect to it. Inkscape also has vector-based effects, and they are editable and they are quite nice and can do certain nice things. So let's go to Path and Path Effects. And there you need to click on the plus and then scroll through all these nice things and go to the knot. Just click on it and you see Inkscape has created it. And it has also created gaps, which are in these options. And you can change the gap link here and maybe change it to 1. And when we make a very short gap, you also see the problems with this function, and you see it doesn't adjust to the curvature of these paths. Also, when the paths meet at other angles than 90 degrees, then this is problematic. So it's not looking nice, but it works for angles of 90 degrees quite well. And it's also nicely editable. So let's take a look at some of the things you can do. Let's change the gap to 2 again, like so. And we can go into the group to edit it. Just double click it and you are in a kind of isolation mode. And then what we can do is change the cap of the stroke to round. And you see the function adjusts to that. Also, when I'm moving this around, you see that the crossings are adapted to this. This is also nice because this is nice for editability. So when I draw another circle to that, it just adapts to this, like so, which is nice. I'm going to double click outside, and then this is just that group again. And I can change to a different tool, which is the node tool. And you see there's this kind of widget here, and you can click on that. And you see when you click on it multiple times, then the crossing changes. And you can take it and move it to a different crossing and then click on that as well. And that's how you edit all these crossings of that knot. That's also nice. So when you have a flowchart or org chart, then you rather have these kind of straight lines. They meet at 90 degrees. So you have your lines group them, and then go to the path effects, add the knot in here. There we have the crossings, and then you can adjust all of them. Go to that selection tool and then edit how this looks. Now the next thing is, this is a live effect. Like in Illustrator, in order to get this into Illustrator to further edit your org chart, what you need to do is turn that into paths. So what you need to do is go to path and then object to path. And now it's no longer an effect. And when I ungroup this now, you see it doesn't change. So this is now really baked into it, and then you can save it as an SVG or a PDF and then open that in Illustrator to further edit it. Make sure you keep your original Inkscape file, so when your organization or your flowchart needs to be edited, then you can adjust it. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.